Hello and welcome to the Daily Mill for Wednesday, 5th of July 2023. Now, after the awful news that reached us yesterday, as expected, the tributes have been flooding in for John Berylson from all over the football world, all across the media. Not only former Millwall players who actually worked and dealt with John Berylson, but fans of other clubs as well. Fans of other clubs, other clubs' websites, all kinds of people in the football world. And it's very interesting to see. Very interesting to see. I don't think ever seen such outpouring for a football chairman. Football chairman, not usually universally liked by their own clubs, but especially not by the rest of the football world. But it seems that John Berylson was. We have this from millfc.co.uk. Steve Kavanagh putting up a statement message. This is unquestionably the hardest thing I've ever had to write in my life. John was without any doubt whatsoever the best club owner I've ever worked with. And I would argue strongly that he was the best chairman of any club in this country. What he did for Millwall over so many years was both extraordinary and exemplary. He trusted his staff to get on with the task at hand, but was always unwavering in his support in so many ways. John's endless passion for Millwall was infectious. He was so incredibly dedicated to the club, and year after year showed remarkable energy and drive to keep us progressing on and off the pitch. There have been ups and downs, sure, but in my view, many more of the former. And as we know, John enjoyed nothing more than to light up a big cigar in celebration of a famous win, promotion or other deserving achievement. His regular visits to the Den became increasingly memorable as the support for him from the fan base grew further with every passing season. He loved the time he would spend walking the perimeter of the stadium to speak to supporters, and his lap of honour before the final game of the season, in hindsight, an even more profound moment now, was amazing to witness. I feel so desperately sad for John's family, and our thoughts and prayers are with them. And what is just such a devastatingly cruel time. Gary, his coaching staff and the players remain out in Spain, and it is the wishes of the family that they continue there to focus on preparations for the season. They will all visit the Den upon their return to pay their respects accordingly. John was hugely excited about the season and their focus, and all of that, and that of all the staff is on ensuring we achieve what he so desperately wanted us to do. On behalf of the club, I would like to thank all of those in the football family who have reached out with messages of condolence. It's been an incredibly emotional experience reading through them, especially those from Millwall fans. And please be assured that everything will be passed on to the family. Thank you to everyone for your support in this incredibly challenging time. We will ensure your legacy lives on, John. Thank you for everything. Rest in peace. So, there you go, there's Steve Kavanagh's statement now, because we have details of the Bookman condolence. Everyone at Mill Football Club is in mourning following the tragic sudden loss of our beloved chairman, John Berylson. An exceptionally loyal, dedicated and wonderful man, John's family, friends and everybody associated to the club, past and present, will now take the time to grieve and remember our chairman. Supporters can pay their respects via a book of condolence to be shared with the Berylson family, which is now open at the Den. On Thursday and Friday, the book will be open from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m, whilst on Saturday and Sunday it will be open from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. So just the 4 days there, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. For those who are unable to make it to the Den, messages can be left via the online book of condolence below. Messages received will then be shared with the Berylson family. Rest in peace, Mr. Chairman. So, you know, John Berylson, condolence. Leave your name, leave your message, and then click send. So many Millwall fans have been going down to the den today. I'm not sure if the book of condolence is up yet. Obviously, it's Wednesday today. But this is set up now. Obviously, they've set up the queuing system. And they put up some shirts and some flowers, etc. This is from LondonNewsOnline.co.uk, the South London Press's online website. Millwall fans head to the Den to pay respects to the late owner, John Berylson. Millwall fans have headed to the Den to pay their respects to Chairman John Berylson, who passed away yesterday. The Lions confirmed the loss of their 70-year-old owner in a tragic accident. And tributes have flowed in from the club's fanbase and ex-players, including owners at other clubs. Former Millwall winger Jed Wallace has travelled down to SC16 this morning to pay his respects to the American. First became involved with the Lions in 2006. And there's been an outpouring of grief from those who worked or dealt with Berylson, the Boston-based businessman, made Millwall a stable club, which has been a continual championship playoff contender in recent seasons. See? Messages and whatnot. Wallace tweeted last night, it's Jed Wallace, not Wallace. Leader, chairman and friend, only a couple of weeks ago, on the phone to hearing this shocking news. I can't imagine how everyone within the club feels. Thank you for everything you did for me and my family, Mr. Chairman. Your legacy will live on forever. And then you've got former Lions defender Danny Sender. You've got Steve Parrish, the Crystal Palace chairman. I'm not going to read them all. There's just so many. The video will be like 2 hours long. Darren McAnany, Peterborough chairman. And they come wall art on Twitter. You can see them. Another Millwall fan. Here's Millwall statement put out over there. Sean Williams reply. Richard Shaw. John Marquis. This is just a small sample. It just goes on and on. Gary Alexander. Cardiff City fan here. Just so many people around footballing world, the real footballing world, mostly lower leagues, I should say. And here we go. This is from southernnews.co.uk. Former Millwall attacker Jed Wallace makes trip to the Den to sign the book of condolence. The stadium was open to the public at 11 a.m. on Wednesday morning, so it was there from 11 a.m. Today. A former Millwall attacker, Jed Wallace, made the trip to the Den on Wednesday, signed a book of condolence for owner John Berylson. Millwall opened the Den for those who wanted to pay their respects to Berylson, who died on Tuesday. Wallace was signed 3 times by Berylson, twice on loan from Wolverhampton and Wanderers before a permanent deal in the summer of 2017. Wallace made 260 appearances for the Lions, played in the 1-0 League One playoff final win over Bradford at Wembley in 2017. He left Millwall last summer for West Bromwich Albion. The Den opened from 11 a.m. on Wednesday morning with supporters forming queues and leaving Millwall jerseys with messages on them to Berylson. So you can see there, he's in Jed Wallace's interaction with the fan. And then we have this from LondonNewsOnline.co.uk from, I think, Simon News, yeah. John led the fight for Millwall to stay in SC16. Former Bermondsey MP pays tribute to late chairman John Berylson. Former Bermondsey MP Simon News has paid tribute to Millwall chairman John Berylson, who passed away in an accident yesterday. A host of club's former players have already stated their shock at the passing of the 70-year-old Lions owner. News deputy chairman of the Millwall Community Trust said, John Berylson was the most committed, loyal and respected of men. We send our deepest sympathy to Amy and the family at the time of his death, but devastating personal loss. John was the Lions' king. Millwall could not have had a more determined and effective and generous owner and chairman over the last 17 years, and I and so many others will never forget his personal kindness and support. John led the fight for the club's survival in SC16 and saw off Lewisham Council and the boroughs acting to force our club out of Bermondsey. The development of the den and the club's determination to move Millwall into the Premiership must now go on as his legacy. Lions supporters can write in a book of condolence at the Den Stadium today from 11 a.m. or online. So obviously this was about this morning. Millwall legacy. What can we do? What can players do? What can the club do? What can anyone do? Talks of naming stands, statues. I certainly would like to see a black kit this season. Some kind of black in the kit. Black socks, black shorts, maybe just an all black kit. I don't know if that's allowed, if that's in the rules. Maybe even just a permanent kind of a black sleeve or black armband. Kind of a bit of a joke in the past about Liverpool fans, because they kept wearing black armbands all the time, that they should just have it on their kit. But I think maybe we should have it on our kit. Even if it's just the players' kit, not the kit that's sold to the fans, for the next season. I think before that, I think Zampa Road, because it's in Southwark, I think they might be more amiable to having that renamed. I think if it was in Lewisham, it might not be possible to do that the way they are. But I think Zampa Road, what is Zampa anyway? What is that? I looked it up today. Apparently, it's the name of an opera, and it was kind of big at the time in the 1800s when the road system was laid out there. And it's kind of like a orchestral piece that's still kind of practiced today, the overture, the Zampa opera, operique. Obviously, we're not the only business on Zampa Road, so there are other people who need to be considered about any name changes and the costs associated with that. But in terms of what's coming up in the future with all the renewal work that's going to go on, the place is going to be absolutely unrecognisable in probably 5 years. It's going to be just razed to the ground and then rebuilt from the ashes. So why not rename one of the roads? Why not rename Zampa Road to the John Berylson Way? Obviously, it was announced that tragic accident. What are you thinking there? You don't know what's going on. So my first thought was maybe it's 4th of July. Maybe it was fireworks accident. Obviously, it was in the morning over there, so that's probably not an option. And then you think of an accident in the home. Did he fall downstairs or something like that? No, well, got confirmation today that it was car accident. This is from Falmouth Police Department in Massachusetts. News release, fatal crashes from their Facebook page. Update from the immediate release. The deceased vehicle operated from a fatal crash on Sippleset Road on July the 4th, 2023, has been identified as John G. Berylson, 70, Well Leslie Hills, Massachusetts. The cause of the crash remains under investigation. On July the 4th, 2023, at approximately 7:58 a.m., the Falmouth Police and Falmouth Fire Rescue Departments responded to a report of a motor vehicle crash in the area of 120 Sippleset Road. Upon arrival, responders located a single vehicle overturned, resting against the tree. The 70-year-old male operator and sole occupant was trapped inside of the vehicle and was extricated by mechanical means. The operator succumbed to injuries received in the crash and was pronounced dead at the scene. The preliminary investigation revealed that the vehicle, the 2019 Range Rover, was travelling south Sippleset Road when it lost control on a curve and left the roadway. The vehicle rolled over into a ravine, came to a rest against a tree. The crash is being investigated by the Falmouth Police Department and the Massachusetts State Police Collision Analysis and Reconstruction Section. It was a car crash. Quite a bad one, obviously. Was it? It took his life. So yeah, there you go. And on that note, thank you for watching, and goodbye.